Go on, let's see which monsters they'll have in their box today.
Let's see, Rosie gets the first pick, and Unarmed and Rosie still have their prebends. Most likely a Ragdoll because he's super strong against Cleaves, but he's actually going for the Sierra, and there's a Bastet ban on the side of Rosie. So the Cleave with Lucian is most likely off the board, but there's still Unarmed being able to go for this Bulldozer composition or whatever he is going to bring besides that. And the Vanessa is obviously a very good pick against either of these compositions.
Yeah, Rosie is without an hesitation securing that 33% speed lead. He predicted that he was going to win the first round, and he definitely did prepare for Unarmed because he did not spend a single second in picking that speed lead, the strongest speed lead that you can pick. And Unarmed is showing a Molong, and once again, he is showing a different strategy. And I love it.
Yeah, Unarmed again with the surprises. There's a Molong, there's an Icarus. It could most likely be the first win of... No, it could be the first win of Molong. It could be the first really strong Molong draft because Icarus is just super strong paired up with him. And there's a lot of danger going in from these two where there's still a lot of adaptation going into the last three picks. Triana obviously is a very strong pick against these two, and then Tyrannus is also good with a little bit of extra protection. There's Bulfur coming in from Unarmed. Is he going to pair it up again with the Rocky? Might as well be, but he could also save up this Rocky for the last draft.
Yeah, he could also pair it up with an Amelia. It's a very good pick when paired up with Bulwark, but the Terranus is a huge, huge counter to the Molong, but Jemire coming in, that's gonna be able to reset the nukes coming in from both the Molong and the Icarus.
Man, it is so hard to prepare against Unarmed because you just don't know what he's going to bring to the table. And we see the timers of Rosie running out in both of these picks. And I think he picked quite well with the Vigor and the Okeanos, but Vigor gives a lot of stacks on the Bulwark. And the last one, is it going to be a Tableau kind of cleave, or is he going to go for a very different style? We can have anything from Unarmed.
Yeah, we have absolutely no idea what we're going to be seeing here. Yeah, we see a Wind John
Louise.
And Louise coming in. A great pairing with the Molong. And it's gonna be pretty interesting. I would like to see a Molong ban coming in from Rosie here because Molong is looking to be the biggest threat coming in here. And from Rosie's side, it's all looking strong, but Terranus is it's gonna be very, very strong against the entire composition of Unarmed. But it's hard to predict because these are not your typical picks.
There's a Vigor and the Molong. Vigor indeed also being a very, very strong monster going into late because Louise just gives so much protection in the first couple of turns that paired up with the Jemire, it's just super, super safe to go to say you go into a little bit longer game, and Vigor just skills so well into that. But also monsters that go very well into that are monsters that skill with speed and attack. Speed and attack on the Triana side scaling. There's the Tyrannus scaling on defense, also big. And then, of course, Vanessa also going strong. But there's still this nuke that's coming off. And this nuke, there's so much protection on the side of Rosie.
Yeah, there is. And we saw that Rosie's runes are even fast enough to outspeed Unarmed. But the Triana is already down. And the Vanessa passive is procced. So this Jemire, if he's able to knock the Triana out, it's going to be... No, we're going to be able to get a revive from Terranus, but it's looking pretty strong so far from Unarmed.
Yeah, and what is super scary is that if this Jemire would have done the third skill, increasing the cooldown, there's still the Terranus going before the Louise. And that could very well mean that Louise would get, like we see right here, would get provoked. But she procs and almost has her skills up again.
Yeah, this Rain of Stone is going to be big if he manages to stun everyone, and he does. He's going to be getting an extra turn, and there's a lot of pressure on the Jemire. That Jemire is going to be going down soon. But
big
he does
proc,
get
big
a proc.
Proc.
It's a huge proc, resetting the skills of Louise, and Louise is going to be able to put Jemire back up to close to full health.
Yeah, to very close to full health, and also still having the second skill and Amelia, the Bulwark, third skill going up. But this is almost a dead Jamaya, and this Okeanos is going to be able to wipe it out.
He chooses not to go for it because he knows that Triana can finish off the Jamaya. He read the attack bars pretty well, and this Bulwark is at 5 stacks right now, but he steals the soul protection. That's huge because that Triana is going down now, and the Terran is S3 is on cooldown.
The Terran is cooldown, is on cooldown, and this Bulwark still has 5 stacks. This could be another nuke coming in very short, very soon. There's no heal on the side of Rosie. Is this Tyrannus going to be able to go into his cycle enough, into his third skill, or is there enough damage on the side of Unarmed with this Dark Sylphid going into third skill again?
Yeah, I think there is not enough damage coming in from Unarmed side because none of these units except the Dark Sylphid S3 is really known to deal damage. That's why I do believe that the Terranus will be able to cycle back to his third skill, but who knows, it's gonna be a slow game right now. We have to see, the procs are gonna matter a lot when things are this close.
Yeah, they are going to matter a lot, and bear in mind that this Louise has such a big heal coming up, and Rosie doesn't have any heals packed with this kit. So this is going to be a long game with a lot of heals, and is there enough damage on the side of Vanessa and Tyrannus going into the long game? There's so much damage going into this Dark Sylph right now, and it is going down.
Yeah. Rosie does not have heals, but he has something that Unarmed doesn't have, the Terranus revives, that is giving him the safety, and it's looking very, very, very good for Rosie right now.
Yeah, but this is a composition that Unarmed brought that is so strong into these comps of Rosie. Rosie was early enough with the Vanessa, with the Triana to adapt to it, but if he didn't have those monsters, it would have been looking very, very grim. So well done on Unarmed on preparation wise, but Rosie as well, adapting appropriately, seeing the pressure very early with this Molong and the Icarus, and he was able to bring the Triana and the Tyrannus Reviver.
Ulti, there is a reason Rosie won the Euro Cup last year, and I think we saw it there. I mean, the guy prepared brilliantly well, and Unarmed came to the table, you know, as DGP said, very, you know, equally as prepared. But Rosie just read everything. He just knew exactly what was going on.
You could just see experience flowing out of this man in this draft because as DGP said, if that first pick was something else, he could have been in a world of trouble. But already the first pick was countering the strategy that Unarmed was going to be bringing. And he knows that Vanessa, the speed lead, is going to be huge against Unarmed's fast swift set. And he knows that the revive is going to be huge because Unarmed is usually going for those explosive first turns.
What do you think Unarmed's going to bring to this set two? He has to win the next two in a row here, DGP. What's going to happen?
It's so hard to answer your question. You can see anything from this guy. It could be a Bulldoze, it could be Illusion, it could be a Molong composition, it could be basically anything, as long as you need big swift sets, because this is what Unarmed has, very, very strong swift set. There is the Draco pre-ban and the Vanessa pre-ban. Vanessa showed so strong in the composition of Rosie, and Draco obviously is something to think of in the cleave compositions.
Yeah, we know that cleave is not the most popular way of going into these tournaments, but we see all of these players facing Unarmed respecting that and banning the Bastet into Draco, into Bastet. I like that respect coming in from all these players. And Rosie does not have the protection of Vanessa this time, but he can go for the... Oh my god, it's
he's
happening.
He's going in we're big! He is going... It. Going in big and he's going in fast. There's Illusion and there is Julie. Sorry about that. Julie also being very strong with a lot of damage on her, a lot of great scaling, but she needs full HP for the highest, for the best potential of her skills. So is this something that Rosie can adapt to? We have fast enough. This is Jamaya and Tablo. This is a huge cleave coming from Unarmed.
It's a cleave that you see in the ladder once in a while. The Jamaya Tablo, they work so well together. Tablo is going first, or the Bastet, then Lucian or Julie, and then Lucian, and then Jamaya is there to reset it, and the same thing happens once again. But that Leo pick is the perfect counter for this, because as we talked about previously, Leo is a great counter pick against Tablo.
Yeah, Leo is a great counter pick, and there's a Lucian preban. So is this enough damage on this Julie with attack buff, with two turns, two third skills going in against Rosie? But there's also obviously the Rectal passive that's going to kick in, and there's the Triana. There's a lot of wind on the side of Rosie. There's Diana also going in. Rosie prepared well. Rosie is going to show how you deal with Cleaves or not, because unarmed, knowing him, is just super strong in these Cleaves.
Yeah, but this Diana is gonna play a huge factor here. She might even cut in after this set, because thanks to the Ragdoll and thanks to the Diana passive, we're gonna have to see. There's gotta be huge crits coming in on the wind if unarmed has any chance to win this game.
Yeah, and the scaling of Julie is super strong, but there is still this heavy wind factor. I see a lot of glancing, do I not?
I think so as well, and this Diana does cut in, and this is spelling the end of unarmed in this tournament, because this is going to be a dead Julie, and even if it's not, she is not full HP for sure, so she won't be getting the max stacks on the third skill.
Yeah, she is not, but this is also a Diana that is looking very grim into this state of her game. And the Tableau, is he going to move first? No, it doesn't look like it. This is Julie going down, and this spells, like you said, probably the end of unarmed. And Rosie showing dominance again. He prepared super well against these Cleaves. The first composition was hard to prepare against, but he was there early in the drafting already with the Vanessa, with the Triana. And even though not picking the Ragdoll in that composition, he didn't have it. It was enough. So very well done by Rosie. Very, very well done by unarmed. Because how often do you kick out Baus? How often do you play so well against Shen? How often are you able to have so much fun in the SWC and show all the viewers how fun Cleaves can be, how strong Cleaves can be, and how preparation is able to work out?
I think I agree with your statement fully, and I think that thanks to unarmed, we're going to be seeing a lot more Cleaves towards the end of this season. And as we talked about earlier, that Ragdoll is such a crucial pick against these cleaving units, and we saw here why. And when you bring in this Tableau Jamire cleave, you open yourself up to a Leo counter pick and Leo Ragdoll together. Who do you ban? Either way, he would have lost. And sadly, it had to be the Leo taken out and Ragdoll finishing him off.
Wow. There we have it, chaps. There we have it. Rosie goes through. Last year's champion has qualified